Hello everyone, welcome to all of you in my English channel Elite English Club. And today I brought for class 11th chapter 4 from Hornbill book Landscape of the Soul. So let's start. Before knowing the chapter, we will know about Nathalie Trouvray. Nathalie Trouvray is an art historian who came in limelight because of her translated work City of Zins, a book by William Dalrymple. She is the wife of Belgian ambassador to India. She has traveled various cities of the world with her husband. She holds a master's degree in history of art and archaeology from University of Belgium. She plans to write her next book on Old Delhi architecture like Jama Masjid and Chandni Chowk. So we will know about the lessons introduction. This chapter comprises of two parts and Nathalie Trouvray is the author. The author has taken the first part from the Landscape of the Soul, Ethics and Spirituality in Chinese Painting. Whereas the second part has been derived from Getting Inside Outsider Art. Getting Inside is an article that was published in the Hindustan Times in 2005. It is written by Brinda Suri. The main theme of the chapter is about arts. It revolves around the art of painting told through the help of various stories. We learn about Chinese painters and their works as well as the story behind them. Similarly, the second part explores the concept of art brut, meaning thereby the art of the ones who have no right. Thus, we learn a great deal about art and its history. Now we will see the summary of the chapter. This chapter divides into two parts as I told you in the introduction of the chapter, each telling us about art and its history through various stories. There are total three stories around it. In the part taken from Landscape of the Soul, Ethics and Spirituality in Chinese Painting. Here we will compare two type of arts or painting and we will see the history and their style. We learn about the art of painting through two stories. The first one is about a very popular Chinese painter Wu Daozi. It is about the 8th century when he was hired by the Tang Emperor Xuanzong to adorn a wall of the palace. Wu painted beautiful scenery with mountains, waterfalls, forests, as well as clouds and blue skies, with people living harmoniously in a happy environment. However, he painted a cave at the foot of a mountain that was inhabited by a spirit. When the painter was showing his work to the emperor, he claps his hands and entrance to the cave opens, where he gets in and vanishes. Thus, after disappearing, the author says that denotes the knowledge of the mystical inner world. Thus, it says that only the masters are aware of the way within and can go yonder any material form. Similarly, there is another story about another popular Chinese painter who did not draw a dragon's eye, fearing it that it would become real and fly out of his painting. Next, we have the third one about a master blacksmith, Quentin Massey. Quentin Massey, who falls in love with the daughter of a painter, as the father was not accepting of his son-in-law belonging to such a profession. He still did so. He accepted Quentin because he painted a fly on his boat. It had such gentle realism that it resembled a real one. Further, the author also talks about Chinese philosophy, Shan Shui, meaning mountain water. Finally, the second part of Getting Inside, Outsider Art by Brinda Suri talks about the concept of art brut, and it translates to the art of the ones who have no right to be artists because they lack any formal training yet somehow possess artistic talent and insight. She refers to them as the ones who think outside the box and defy the normal standards. People refer to their work as unorthodox art. She cites the example of Nick Chin's work at Rock Garden in Chandigarh as a form of art brut because he does not have any education regarding that, and he has the talent and insight. So he made it. To sum up landscape to soul summary, we learn that art is an infinite form which has a rich history and it cannot fit inside any certain box or label. It has a life of its own. So I hope you like my story and you liked the chapter. Please keep watching and don't forget to comment in comment box. Till then, take care.